What is it that Lambda does? What do you build and what do you offer?
Lambda is an AI compute platform. We have GPU servers, GPU workstations, and a GPU cloud service that we provide to AI developers.
And so this money is a significant Series C. We've done a lot on this show about the build-out and AI infrastructure. We're literally talking server designs going into data centers normally run by the hyperscalers. What are you going to take that cash and do with it?
Well, we're going to be deploying tens of thousands of new NVIDIA GPUs into our data center and providing those GPUs as part of our cloud service.
Okay. Go back to the origin story here, Stephen, because it's an interesting one. You weren't always in this game. In fact, you were making facial recognition technology and ways in which I could augment my face via AI. And then your own bills for your own cloud consumption got too high. So tell us that.
Yeah, so Lambda started off as a face and image recognition software development company. So we were AI engineers ourselves. And we ended up getting a really high cloud service bill. And we figured, you know what? It was a lot more cost effective for us to redesign and reimagine what an AI cloud should look like in the age of training neural networks and inferencing neural networks. And so that's how we pivoted into the cloud business that we're in today.
And Stephen, I really want to try and understand competitors versus frenemies. I find it very hard to basically get to grips with who you're servicing, who your clients are, because it looks as though some of your clients are even some of the hyperscalers that ultimately you're going in competition with. Can you just tell us how ultimately you think the lay of the land will look like in 5 years' time?
Yeah, so Lambda's customers include, you know, trillion-dollar market cap, Fortune 500 companies, companies that are major enterprises like Rakuten who are integrating AI into their products and services, and venture-backed startup companies like Anyscale. And so, you know, we really primarily provide and cater towards that AI developer, and that's who we've been basically providing our services to.
Steve, I'm just really interested on the hardware side of this story. So, you know, I'm assuming that you guys are building out your infrastructure with DGX or HGX, right? The broader server design. But what's happening right now in 2024, remarkably quickly, as we're kind of moving from this focus on training to inference and understanding the energy and compute load for inference, do you then start looking elsewhere at like AMD, their MI300X? How do you transition your own footprint in business?
So look, today Lambda is exclusively providing NVIDIA GPUs. And the reason for that is because that's what the market's demanding, right? You know, it's very simple. We are a compute provider that, technically speaking, and from our software architecture and our software platform, is agnostic to what the underlying accelerator platform is. But so far today, we've been pure NVIDIA.
Let's look at the valuation and let's look at the money you raised. Valuation is high. Talk to me about the reality of your business from a revenue generation standpoint, which markets you operate in outside of North America, the number of customers you have. I think we're learning about you and we're thinking, well, hold on, this sounds like you're a really key part of the system.
So Lambda's been pretty under the radar. But we have over 10,000 customers. In fiscal year 2022, we did over $100 million of shipped GAAP revenue. Last year, we did over $237 million of shipped revenue. So we already have a pretty substantial business. And in terms of valuation, I think that you're looking at these revenue multiples and you're probably thinking, wow, that's actually quite reasonable given the growth, given the customer base, and given the just sheer amount of revenue we have.